Dr. Neha Jain, I am presenting a topic on orthotics. I am an associate professor in Mahatma Gandhi Occupational Therapy College in Department of Occupational Therapy College. First of all, we will know about orthotics, the subject dealing with orthosis. Orthosis basically is a device or appliance prescribed by doctor for specific conditions affecting the limbs or trunks. For example, amputation, fracture. Orthotist. Who is an orthotist? Orthotist is a person who manufactured the orthotis. It may orthosis come ready-made these days, as there are less companies which are specialized in manufacturing orthosis. You basically read and basically see many kind of orthotist and orthosis in your daily living activities. For example, crutch, cranes, wheelchair, walkers. Prosthetics. Orthotics and prosthetics are deal together in the field of rehabilitation. Prosthetics are the subject dealing with prosthesis. Prosthesis is a device or appliance. It prescribe and used to replace a removed, absent or amputated part of the body. For example, a person met with an accident and he got a trauma, and after that the amputation happened of hand, below knee, above knee, below hip. There are many kind of amputation, and according to that amputation we provide the suitable prosthetic to the person. Who is a prosthetist? Prosthetist is a person who makes the prosthesis, who basically makes the artificial limbs. Orthoses are used on limbs and trunks in a variety of conditions affecting the musculoskeletal system. As I told you earlier, that orthoses are the devices which are aids towards our ADL. Orthoses basically we use in many conditions. They are congenital, traumatic, degenerative and neurological. Orthotics calipers. Traditionally, calipers were the most known form of orthosis. Caliper is a device which is applied to lower limb to give support or control a joint. As you are viewing in the picture, that it is a picture of a caliper. Caliper basically help to the weak limb part to move and support it to control the joint movement and muscle. Function of orthosis. It prevents deformity, it correct deformity, it maintain correction, controls instability, and it relieves weight bearing. It facilitates ambulation. Ambulation means it helps you in moving from one place to another. It relieves pain, as it controls the joint movement and maintain the musculature. So it helps you in relieving pain. Orthosis prescription. Now it is a very important part to know that how you should prescribe orthosis, or who can prescribe prosthosis. The doctor ordering or prescribing an orthosis should understand the functional needs of the patient and to provide the orthotist with an exact prescription that specific the material, the joints, the joint position and range of motion to be allowed. For example, in this orthosis prescription, somebody needs to know the requirement of the patient and what problem or what in what condition patient is, and what joint should be supported, what range of motion should be enhanced, what joint should not be supported. You should keep in mind in that. Old terminology is still commonly used. There are many splints like von Rosen splint, that is frog splint, rigid hip abduction splint, surgical corset, that we call lumbar orthosis. We basically used it to give lumbar support. Surgical shoes, foot orthosis, below knee calipers, AFO, above foot orthosis, above knee caliper, KAFO, knee, ankle, foot orthosis. Functions of orthosis. First is, it will help in preventing deformity. Examples of ankle foot orthosis are ankle foot orthosis if paralytic drop foot following polio and sciatic nerve injury. To prevent development of equinus, dynamic fingers, it is wrist splint in dropped wrist. It following radial nerve palsy to prevent development of fingers and wrist flexion deformity. There are many deformities which happen in wrist and fingers if we will not use orthosis. Prevention of deformity, that is ankle foot orthosis. Drop wrist in radial nerve palsy. It basically seen in fracture junctions of mid and lower third of humerus. Radial nerve palsy makes loss of wrist and metacarpopharyngeal joints dorsiflexion. Nerve function recovers with passage of time if it will not cut. Prevention of deformity is important and it is prevented by the use of orthosis only. So this is basically how a radial palsy splint look like. Now we will come to prevention of deformity in brachial plexus palsy. Brachial plexus palsy usually leads to loss of shoulder abduction and external rotation. And if it is not treated, it leads to abduction and internal rotation deformity. It is like taking a tip position. Abduction orthosis is used to prevent this deformity. Brachial plexus injury is usually a stretching injury. It basically happens when person will fall on the overstretched hand. So shoulder should be splinted in functional position awaiting nerve recovery. Also active and passive exercises and electrical nerve stimulation should be done. Electrical nerve stimulation should be done to enhance the nerve stimulation and nerve conduction. And active and passive exercises are basically used for the joint compression. Now we will come to corrections of deformity. It is foot orthosis, shoe raise to compensate for shortness, spinal orthosis, these are cervico-dorso-lumbar orthosis, Milwaukee orthosis to prevent increase of deformity and correct deformity during growth. An orthosis will not correct a fixed bony deformity or fixed joint contracture. It basically support the joint and enhance joint range of motion. Correction of deformity, foot orthosis by shoe raise or heel cup. This is basically how heel cup look like. Shoe raise is a simple orthosis which corrects limb length asymmetry. Limb length asymmetry is, have you heard about limb length discrepancy, limb lurching? These are the basically terms used for limb length asymmetry. The person is having lurching gait because of the difference in the length of the both limbs. Heel cups inserted into shoes may prevent development of varus and valgus heel deformity. Are used in deformities in excess of 25 degrees of Cobb's angle. Are used in growing individuals. To be effective, they have to be used for 24 hours daily. They have to be used till bone growth keys. Spinal orthosis. Spinal orthosis are of many types, can be rigid or semi-rigid. It depends upon that whether you have to support the whole joint, mid joint and flexible joint. Most comprehensive form is Milwaukee brace. Cervico dorso lumbosacral orthosis. Boston brace or Jett brace is a type of rigid dorso lumbosacral orthosis. When we compare all the spinal orthosis, Milwaukee brace is a very common brace. These braces are also used, Boston brace and Jett brace, but it is not used as much as Milwaukee brace is used. May be concealed under the clothes. Can control deformities or injuries at lumbar spine as well as dorsal lumbar spine up to level D6. How this orthosis looks like. Can control scoliotic or kyphotic deformities. Both are spine deformities. Milwaukee brace. This is basically Milwaukee brace. How it looks like. It support your whole joint also plus the साइड में इज पार्ट ऑफ योर ज्वाइंट ऑल्सो. नाउ विल कम टू स्पाइनल ऑर्थोसिस. सर्वाइको डोर्सो लंबर ऑर्थोसिस कैन कंट्रोल ऑल स्पाइनल डिफॉर्मिटीज. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ थ्री बेसिक कॉम्पोनेंट्स. फर्स्ट इज पेल्विक गर्डल, द वर्टिकल बार्स, द मैंडिबुलो ऑसिपिटल असेंबली. द थ्री कॉम्पोनेंट्स आर इंडिविजुअली मेड फॉर द पेशेंट. वेन फिल्ड फर्स्ट इट शुड नॉट बी स्ट्रेस्ड टू मच. थैंक यू सो मच.